Teardrop, 5x10. Today I'm gonna put the sides up on the teardrop. And hopefully everything will go together well. What it is, I screw on a little tab here, and I'll put another tab on the other end. And make sure when you put these tabs on the end that you clamp this together. Your clamp can reach all the way. If you put it too far this way, your clamp won't be able to reach it. So it looks like we're just barely in reach here. That should be enough. I don't make too many holes in the side because I don't want to, that's more holes I gotta fill. Fresh tip, but I guess I ain't getting it today. So let's start with some glue. And I'm not gonna glue it in here because I'm not sure yet if I'm gonna do the hold it, a door that just stops here or when it comes all the way down. I think it's gonna be all the way down, but so we're just gonna throw some glue on this thing. Make sure you get your sides orientated right, because this is my front, and I got my deck where I got the extra seam at the back, so I don't have to worry about having a seam. I'll show you when I get done, because it's only about a foot wide here, and then 4 feet wide, then I have to have 2 foot wide piece on the end, so that's how we're going to go with that. So yeah, get you a thumping hammer. Big one, heavy one. This one's called a BFR. Off there, I will bump it. Pretty much on, right on. Now let's put some screws in it. So if you have not done this before like this, I recommend that you have somebody stay around and watch you in case this thing falls off. If it hits you in the neck, you're pretty much through. probably should have swept up the floor first, huh? But I didn't. Put a screw on the backside to keep it from pushing. When I run the screw up in there, it's pushing the side in just a tad. Sometimes you have to take a little bit of misalignment because it's just it's the nature of the beast. It's homemade, so there's going to be some character to it. Yeah, that's a ticket character. And I'll try to run that thing down like it's a run it down through the blade. We'll just squeeze it out and then give it just a little bit more pressure. I'll show you in just a minute what I'm doing back here. Just sound like a drum. Or tighten it up. Some rag, get you some water, try to clean off the excess glue so you don't have so much extra sanding to do. Thank you. Yeah, it'll be okay. Can't see that with my glass on right there. And down there by the hammer where I put some screws in right at the base. You know, a big piece of wood like this is gonna have some wave in it, so it's up to you to bend the wave out of it. Try to scoot everything over so I have room to work. Now, right, remember this has biscuits in it, so to lift it up, you want to be a little gentle with it, or you can break your biscuit joints. You don't want to break your biscuits, you get a couple smaller screws. These are 1 5/8. You don't need a lot, but you need, you know, you want, when it goes through, you want it to have some grip in there, some thread in it. I always say, put that glue on there like it's free. Straining and grimacing. I always put this part here sticking out to the inside. I'm working under it and I go to stand up, I don't get it in the back of the neck or my head. I'll make sure you bump it flush. Not sure of your view. But I'll make sure it's flush right here. Get you over. See if I can split the view here. That'd be good. Oh, that would be real good. Knock over. This camera makes so much noise when I'm moving. Alright. But next I'll get my pieces I cut off the curb in that they'll go from about here, a little triangle, to hold it up to square while I'm working on it. Just tighten this thing down. Check that, because I don't trust that screw. I really don't. Put my safety measurement back on here. Safety measure. That would sound good. I need to check that one on the inside. It didn't sound right. Sound like it might come through the interior. That looks good. And that's how I get the walls up by myself. It's much easier. This wasn't real bad, but it's just with the extra weight is rough. Okay, you remember these scraps? This in place while we look on it. And I like to use screws because when you use screws, you don't have to, you know, like say this is a claw hammer and you get that screw out, you yank it on it, beat it. Yank everything out of square. It will split. That's just part of it. If you pre-drill this, it would not split. Have to be really super tight in there. You know, you don't have to run that screw down like you're still in a head gasket. Just put it on there and so the screw snugs up. This helps you keep everything in square because you can't use a level on it. I guess you could, but my floor is not level finished. The garage floor is built to drain.